One special guest from our southern neighboring country, Dr. Arvind Alok. He is a member of Heritage Tourism, Ministry of Railway, Railway Board, Government of India, New Delhi, Chairman, Buddhist Monument Development Council, Director, Buddhist Academy of India. So he will deliver general outlooks and greetings to this conference. Overall perspective he will deal about Buddhism. And I compare Buddhism with a tree. The root is Nepal. The trunk is India. The fruit and the leaves, that is China, Japan, Korea, and others. Now it is a global, universal religions. So to spread Buddhism, Nepal and India has contributed a lot. So let us listen to Dr. Arvind Alok. Please, Alok.
Most venerable the bhikkhus, Mr. Chairman of this session, Sri Shrestaji, this occasion is graced by the Honorable Minister for Culture and Tourism, Sri Adhikari Ji, Excellencies, Member of Parliament, my co-panelists here at the dais, distinguished scholars, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I take this opportunity to express my sincere thanks to Lumbini Development Board for inviting me to be here to interact with you and to join you in the celebration of the birth of Sakyamuni the Buddha. Friends, the inauguration session started yesterday and today the session is going on, and in course of the deliberations and presentation of the papers, I can have an idea as to how once upon a time in this auspicious land of Nepal, Buddha was born, and his ideals and teachings spread to the world. Of course, Buddha was born here, but he got enlightenment in Bodh Gaya, and he spent his almost longest time in India preaching and teaching the Dhamma for the emancipation and welfare of the mankind. Friends, we are assembled here not only for celebration of the birth of the Buddha, but here we are gathered to give a clear message to the entire world that how peace is important nowadays. If the world has to sustain and remain peacefully, blissfully, then the message of the Buddha is so important. Buddha said, Nahi vairena vairani samanti dha kudachanam avairena cha samanti esa dhammo shanantano. The only option we have, that we have to live peacefully, tolerantly, compassionately, and for that only the message of the Buddha is relevant today. I compliment also the government of Nepal for initiating this dialogue on such a beautiful occasion that deliberations are coming and giving a message to the entire world that how Nepal is trying to preserve the Buddhist legacy of India. Friends, I take this also opportunity to tell you that India and Nepal both are interrelated. The Buddhist legacy of Nepal, the Buddhist legacy of India are so interrelated that it is difficult to separate. You will find the fragrance of Buddhism here, and you will find the fragrance of Buddhism in India also. In course of my visits to at least 60 countries for my lectures and participations in conferences and meetings, I have always told that Buddhist circuit is incomplete if you go to India and do not visit Nepal, and if you go to Nepal and do not visit India. Therefore, this togetherness is very important for today, and the entire world look at us for the clear and clarity about the teachings of the Buddha, about the Buddhist circuit. Friends, we lost our legacy, we lost our culture, we lost our ideals, but now it is good that we are trying to revive this Buddhist legacy in Nepal also, in India also. We have been proud of that our respective governments recently, Prime Minister Oli was in Delhi, I met him also, formerly also Mr. Deva was there, I met him also. So the need of the hour is that both the governments and the people should work together, not only for the development of Buddhist circuit, for the promotion of the teachings of Buddha, but also to give a message to the world that how Nepal and India coexist together, complement each other. And I would like to quote a very good Sanskrit saying, O Yodhurvani Paritajya, Adhurvani Nishevate, Dhurvani Tasya Nashyanti, Adhurvam Nastimevahi. What we had already, we must preserve it. Otherwise, if we hang after those things which are not sure, we will lose our original thing also and other things also. Therefore, it is very important that what we were gifted by the teachings of the Buddha, at any cost, we should preserve them, and it is in the interest of India and Nepal, all also in the interest of the survival of the whole universe. Again, I quote one of the teachings of the Buddha, Sabba Papasya Akaranam Kusala Saup Sampada Pariyad Padam Etam Buddhana Shashram. With these words, again, I thank you so much for giving me time, Mr. Chairman, but again, I wish and I am sure that this conference will result into a clear-cut deliberation for the people that how we have to live together and also peacefully, blissfully save our destiny. Bhavatu sabba mangalam, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.